way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. And a lot of football, full half to be played. Oh, what a move. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Here on first down, he's gonna look for Allen now on the deep ball, and he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Keenan Allen, the intended receiver, that'll bring up second down.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave him with a third down and 6 to go.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. Defensively, a dime look here. 6 DBs on 3rd and 12.
No surprise at all.
Gabriel, the man in motion. On 3rd down, Ryan. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up 4th down.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Now look at this, 4th and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it. Play clock winding down. Here we go on 4th down with Ryan. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Now a second down throw for Rivers. Over the middle, he's got Tyrell Williams. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. And now the offense operates in the red zone. Now Gordon on 1st down. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Now Rivers escaping the pressure right. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
The Chargers on 3rd down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Working out of the gun, Rivers going underneath for Gordon. And he has the 1st down before he's tackled at the 5. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Throw is Rivers. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 13. He's at the 50. The 30. The 20. 10. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. Short throw, pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football.